Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? Yes, you all are excellent. Today we will continue our last lesson, that is the Book of Moment, from Book of Moment, lesson number 6, Weathering the Storm in Erasma. Weathering the Storm in Erasma, written by Harsh Mandey. We have, in the last lecture, we have heard about author and the short summary of this lesson. Now we will see the detailed explanation of this lesson. Weathering the Storm in Erasma. Erasma is a village, is a place in Orissa, in eastern part of our India. And this story is about a boy named Prashant and how he trapped in super cyclone. Prashant goes to meet his friend who lives 18 kilometers away from his home. That is, what is his home? The Kalipura, where he stays. The name of that place is Kalipura. Here are the two characters are there. One is Prashant, he's a 19-year-old boy, and the second is Prashant's friend. Okay, these two characters we have seen over here. And he and his friend have to stay at the rooftop for 2 days. Now we'll see. After what happened in the last, we see that he says that he becomes the leader of that village and forms a team of volunteers, and which helps to getting food for the victims, those who are there trapped in that flood, that is called the victims, and cleaning the overcrowded shelter also. That is very important. We need the courage. That's why we see in the last lecture, the theme is that we see a courage in this Prashant. And this is not a story, dear children. This is a fact happened. On 27th October 1999, 7 years after his mother's death, Prashant had gone to the block headquarters of Erasma, a small town in coastal area, some 18 kilometers away from his village, to spend the day with a friend. In the evening, a dark and menacing means very dangerous. Menacing storm quickly gathered. Winds beat against the houses with a speed and fury that Prashant had never witnessed before. Heavy and insistent rain failed. Feel the darkness. Rain, feel the darkness. Ancient trees were uprooted. See the ancient trees. Big trees were uprooted in that area. Nowadays, you know, I think so, in those days, in the 1990s, it was there. But now also, we, if something super cyclones, if something, this environment, you know, is going to be happening, the government alerts the people. Understand? And they say that you have to be alert in these days, in this hour, this is going to be come. Because when we were there, we were faced the Nisarga cyclone, they had alerted us. They said the fishermen also not to go in the sea, not to go there, not to go away from your player house. You be at home. So this, but he was not knowing, he was aware of all, and all of a sudden this super cyclone struck that Erasma. Uprooted, the ancient trees uprooted and crashed to the earth. Screams rent the air as people and houses were swiftly washed away, swiftly, very fastly washed away. The angry water swirled, you know, swirling that ghumna, swirling to move incredible, you know, the very in circle, to move in a circle, that is called the swirl. The angry water swirled into his friend's house, neck deep, up to here, neck deep, you know. The building was of brick and mortar. Mortar means building material. Mortar, we have written somewhere. not build the mortar, the building material. Okay, the building mortar and was strong enough to survive the devastation of the wind's velocity. The wind's velocity of 350 km per hour. Means if we start our, means 350 kilometers we can go within 1 hour. See, we can imagine. So that speed of that wind, that's why everywhere destroyed, everywhere destruction happened because of this heavy rainfall and this cyclone, means this wind also. But the cold terror of the family grieved with the crashing of trees that had got uprooted and fallen on their houses. Sometime in the middle of the night, damaging its roof and walls. Sometimes it was the roofs and the walls were also damaging. The crazed destruction wrought. Wrought means cost. Wrought means cost. Okay, now destruction caused by the cyclone and the surge of the ocean continue of the night, surging of the ocean of the continued for the next 36 hours. Although wind speed had reduced, not that much, 360 km per hour, but the wind speed reduced, but the rain and the rainfall, it was raining continuously. Speed had reduced somewhat by the next morning. To escape the waters rising in the house, Prashant and his friends, family had taken a refuge on the top because that water was up to neck. Understand? So they went on the rooftop. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone. Everywhere, you know, devastation, destroy everything caused by this super cyclone. He will not forget anything. And wrought by cyclone surge, Prashant and his friend family had taken a refuge on the rooftop. Prashant will never forget the shock he experienced at his first glimpse of the devastation wrought by the super cyclone in the gray light of the early morning. A ragging means a very violent, wild, ragging, deadly brown sheet of water covered everything as far as the eye could see. Ragging, deadly brown sheets of water covered everything as far as the eyes could see. Only fractured cement houses still stood. Others, the kaccha houses were completely flown away in the water. Only the pakka houses built by cement and that steel and all, it was as it is. Still stood in a few places. Bloated animal, carcasses means, you know, dead bodies. All the dead bodies and the human crops floated in every direction. All round, even huge old trees had fallen. Can you imagine? Old huge trees, if you see, as height is there, that much root goes inside the earth, those trees were also uprooted. We could see a few months, hardly 1 and a half months back, we could see this scene in our Konkan area. Really, we, by the grace of God, we all are fine. But those who have victims, those who suffered, caused because they have suffered, still it is there, like Prashant's mind, it is there. It will not go, it will never go in from in their mind. It's the same thing happened in our Konkan area also. All around, even huge old trees had fallen. Two coconut trees had fallen on the roof of their house. This was a blessing in disguise, you know. Even though that tree fallen on their roof, it was a blessing, God's blessing, because that tree was a coconut tree and it was fallen down. Because of that, they could eat the tender coconut. Okay, that is a discuss in the height something, so that we will not be missed, that in this situation also they could get. Because of the tender coconuts from the trees kept the trapped family from starving in the several days that followed, because of God cares everyone. So here also, he had fallen coconut tree had fallen on their roof, and because of that they were on the roof, they could eat that. How many days they were then top of that roof, those many days they ate that, they could survive, they could, they are alive because of that. For the next 2 days, Prashant sat huddle means group, with his friends, family, in the open on the rooftop at day and night. One night, you know, they were there on the top. They froze in the cold and incessant rain. They were very, it was cold, no, because raining and the cold, they were frozen in the rain. The rain water washed away Prashant's tears. The only thought that flashed through his mind was whether his family had survived the fury of the super cyclone. Fury of the super cyclone, fury means wild and dangerous force. In this dangerous pool, what about my family? It was flashed in his mind. Then what was flashed through his mind was whether his family had survived the fury of the super cyclone. Was he to be bereaved once again? What is meant by this? Sad because of the family. He was very sad because of thinking about his family. 2 days later, which seemed to Prashant like 2 years. Only 2 days he was there in his friend's house on the top of that. But when he was thinking about his family, he thought that, my God, I have not seen my family members from 2 years back. In the sad situation, we always feel these 2 moments, 2 days also, if we feel as if it is very long days. The 2 days later, which will Prashant like 2 years, rain ceased and the rain water slowly began to recede, come down. Prashant was determined to seek out his family without further delay. He wanted to go to his place. To his place, where is place? Kalikuda. Want to see his relatives, mean father, mother, near and dear ones. Still danger, family without further delay. But the situation was still dangerous. And his friend's family pleaded with Prashant to stay back a little while longer. But Prashant knew he had to go. He equipped himself with a long study. Study means very strong stick. Because if we go in the water, in the flooded area, if stock is, stick is there, I mean that is a strong log. We can say the log also. Log floats on the water. It will not sink down. So he found that equipment and with that sturdy stick, the strong stick, and then started off his 18 kilometers expedition back to his village. Through the swollen flood waters, full water was there. It was a journey. He would never forget that. He constantly had to use his stick to locate the road, you know, to locate the road, whether that is road is there or a deep area is there. According to locate the road, that stick was with him, and with the help of that stick, he was going to his place, Kalikuda, where the water was most shallow. At place, it was waist deep and progress was slow. Several points he lost the road and had to swim. Sometimes he couldn't walk, so he swam there and was going further. After some distance, he was relieved to find 2 friends of his uncle who were also returning to their village. He could meet his uncle's friends, okay, and returning to their village, they decided to move ahead together. This uncle's friends and this Prashant, these three were moving towards their place. That is the Kalikuda. As they waded, what is meant by waded, you know? To walk through water with very difficulty. That's called waded. Wade means walking through the difficulty. So here are the past tense of wade. As they waded through the waters, the scenes they witnessed grew more and more macabre. That is unpleasant. They had to push away many human bodies, men, women, children, and the carcasses of dogs. Carcasses, dead body of dogs, goats, and cattle that the current swept against them as they moved ahead. See the very horrible condition. In every village that they passed, they could hardly see a house standing. Hardly few houses were there as it is. Rest all floated in the water, floated in the water. Houses standing, Prashant now wept out loud and long. He was sure that his family could not have survived at a catastrophe. You know, that is a sudden event that causes damage. That is called a catastrophe. Eventually, Prashant reached his village. Okay, his village, Kalikuda. His heart went cold. And where their homes once stood, there were only remnants. Remnants, small remained one. Remnants means few things were there. Everything gone. Remnants of its roof. Some of their belongings were caught, mangled, and twisted in the branches of trees, just visible above the dark waters. Few things around water, trees, branches of trees were visible above the dark waters. Okay, young Prashant decided to go to Red Cross shelter to look for his family, where the government has given the shelter, that is a Red Cross shelter. Among the first people he saw the crowd was his maternal nanny, maternal grandmother. Weak with hunger, she rushed to him. You know, she saw that his grandson, and she rushed towards him. Her hands outstretched like this, Her eyes brimming, प्यार से उसके आँखें उसके अपने पोते को देखने के लिए यो गए. It was a miracle. They had long given him up for dead. God has escaped them from death. You know, so it was a miracle. Quickly word spread and his extended family gathered around him and hugged him tight in relief. When his relatives saw him, they came everyone and everybody hugged him in relief, satisfaction. No, he's also safe. Prashant anxiously scanned a motley. What is meant motley? Despair, pain and sad. Disparate, sad motley. Battered. Battered means injured. They were injured very badly. Group, his brother and sister, his uncles and aunts, and they all seemed to be there. By the next morning, as he took in the desperate situation in the shelter, he decided to get a grip over himself. He sensed a deathly grief setting upon the 2,500 strong crowd in the shelter. 86 leaves were lost in the village. All the 96 houses had been washed away in the flood. It was their fourth day at the shelter. So far they had survived on green coconuts, but there were two leaves to go around. Such a tumult of people, tumult of people, a state of noisy. All were there in the shelter, everywhere noisy, everywhere mess, everywhere of people. Prashant, all of 19 years, decided to step as a leader of the village, of his village, if no one else did. He organized a group of youths and elders to jointly pressurize the merchant once again to part with his rice. This time a delegation succeeded and returned triumphantly, wading through the receding waters with food for the entire shelter. He did that work. He went to the merchants and told them to get food for the people, and he got success and he brought food for the in the shelter for the victims, for the people. No one cared that the rice was already rotting. Branches from the fallen trees were gathered to light a reluctant and slow fire on which to cook the rice. For the first time in 4 days, the survivors at the cyclone shelter were able to feel their bellies. You know, able to feel their. After 4 days, they got something to eat. His next task was to organize a team of youth volunteers to clean the shelter off of it, because wherever we are staying, that people wherever, so that must be cleaned. So that he told the volunteers to clean that also. Urine, vomit and floating carcasses, dead bodies, and to tend to the wounds and fractures of the many who had been injured, giving the first aid to the injured people also. On the fifth day, a military helicopter flew over the shelter and dropped some parcels. It then did not return. After that, it did not, only one day they had given. The youth task force gathered empty utensils from the shelter. Then they deputed the children to lie in the sand left by the waters around the shelter with these utensils on their stomach. Then once they had come, the helicopter come, they did not return. Then he said that few children to sit or lie on the sand and keep that empty vessel on your stomach. Means they could see that, they will see that and they can understand that yes, they need the food. And they got victory in that also. Stomachs to communicate to the passing helicopters that they were hungry. The message got through, and after that the helicopter made regular rounds of the shelters, airdropping food and other basic needs. Other basic needs, clothes we want, for the blankets, the bed sheet, for wearing clothes and all, you know, all these things they need. So when he kept like that, so they could understand. So regularly the helicopter was taking round. Prashant found that a large number of children had been orphaned. Many people, because their houses were not there, floated away, everything washed away. So many widows, they were nobody was there with them. The orphan were there. So he gave shelter to everyone. Number of children had been orphaned. He brought them together and put up a polythene sheet shelter for them. You know, we put the polythene shelters there like a jhopri cottage, temporary house. Women were mobilized to look after. Mobilized means to see everywhere. Whatever they need, you can supply, you can do that work to look after them, while the men secured food and materials for the shelters. Ladies, he gave the woman, the widow woman and all other women, those who were not having anything, to look after these orphan children, and the men, the gents were doing the taking care of their food. As the weeks passed, Prashant was quick to recognize that women and children were sinking deeper and deeper in their grief. He persuaded the woman to start working in the food for work program started by an NGO. And for the children, he organized sport events. Slowly, slowly, he was completely taking care of these people. He himself loved to play cricket, and so he organized cricket matches for children. Prashant engaged with other volunteers in helping the widows and the children to pick up the broken pieces of their lives. The initial government plan was to set up institutions for orphans, and widows. However, this step was successfully resisted, as it was felt that in such institutions, children would grow up without love, and widows would suffer from stigma and loneliness. Prashant's group believed orphans should be resettled in their own community itself, possibly in new foster families made up of childless widows. Even though they are widows, but they were not having child. That is called a childless widows and children without adult care. It is 6 months after the devastation means happened, whatever happened there that caused by destruction, that is the devastation. It is the 6 months after the devastation of the super cyclone. This time Prashant's wounded spirit has healed simply because he had no time to bother about his own pain. See, he had his pain, his family's pain, but it was vanished because he was taking care of everyone. That is when we do the best work, you know, helping, lending hand to others, we get one type of satisfaction. So he got that satisfaction and he bothered about his own pain. He couldn't recognize his own pain only because he was helping completely day and night to these widows, orphans, and those who were helpless. He was helping needy, he was helping them. His handsome, youthful face is what the widows and orphan children of his village seek out most in their darkest hour of grief. So, this is a story happened on 27th October 1999 in the place Irisma, small place in Irisma in Orissa. Written by Harsh Mandel. I think so, dear children, you understood this lesson very clearly. I read once again this lesson and try to understand. Thank you and have a nice day.